a few more important questions than this. Quite often we use the word, but gospel, but do we have the same dictionary? Whilst we're using the same vocabulary, do we mean the same thing from what we're saying? Now, the gospel, first and foremost, is news. So I should say three things about news. One, it has to be newsworthy. Two, news has results. And three, it has a background. So it has to be newsworthy. If I told you that I had breakfast today, that is true, but that's not newsworthy. Whereas if I told you the result of the election, that's newsworthy. Second thing is that news always has results or effects or consequences. So if the GDP of Nigeria rose astronomically today, well, it's going to have an effect, which is hopefully the prosperity of its citizens. And then third thing is background. If I said, for instance, today that a female became president of the nation, you need to have the background that we've never had a female ascend to that office to make it more meaningful. So with that having been said, let me give you a definition of the gospel that you can extract from Romans 1 and 1 Corinthians 15. It is the good news that the incarnate crucified Savior, Jesus Christ, is the risen Lord and impending judge of the world. Let me break down some of those words and show why it's important. Incarnate means that God became a human being to come and save. Then crucified Savior means that the means through which he saved the world was by dying on a cross. Risen Lord means that he rose from the dead into new and immortal life, which he promises his people. Impending judge means that he hasn't returned, but he will return to deal with evil once and for all, and also establish good. Now, if you believe that message, then the good effects of the gospel then comes to us. We become saved, and we look forward to life everlasting with Jesus Christ.